first boss of Sonic 3 and Knuckles is this machine that blows fire and stuff. And you know what? Just sit here with your little fire shield and just jump into it, it dies. I mean, robots die, they feel pain. Yeah, I learned it from Nier Automata, so it's dead. That's all. The next boss is the Egg Scorcher MK3. There's a lot of Egg Scorchers. Wait a minute. Anyways, so when he first shows up here, you gotta hit him a few times, but you can, and you gotta quickly get off the bridge, because you'll fall to your death, obviously. And that's never a good thing. Just keep hitting Robotnik, Eggman, Robotnik. I'm gonna say Robotnik. Too bad. And just, you know, just hit him, dodge, fire. Simple. Easy. Good start. Yes, this is gonna have all the Knuckles bosses this time, I promise, because last time it didn't. Yeah. The next boss is the Big Shaker. At least that's what it says. So, this thing's kind of fucking annoying. We got our bouncy bubble here. We're gonna bounce ourselves and spin ourselves to victory as we just wait for this boss to just stop trying to ram us to death. So as you can see, we're bouncing into it here, trying to prevent ourselves from going with the spin cycle. And we did it! Fuck the spin cycle. Fucking Hydrocity Zone. It's Hydrocity, not Hydro City. The next boss is the Egg Vortex. So, Robotnik, he's had enough of you. He's gonna make a small little whirlpool, kind of. Anyways, jump into him if you can, and try not to get sucked into the middle, because you don't want to get slashed by Robotnik's propeller. You can also, you know, of course, jump on the water, as you just seen, and hit him. He'll also drop out these landmines that explode, and hey, you can also ride the explosion up. Don't do it. Unless you're crazy. I'm pretty crazy. But yeah, overall, it's okay. I almost goofed, but you know, Tails with the fucking MVP save. Because you know, sometimes Tails is good. Sometimes. Other times, Tails is fucking horrible. The next boss is this tunnel bot. Memories of Sonic 2 and the Drill Machine. So obviously spikes are bad. Boss is bad. And don't touch the spikes on the boss. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. Aaron, you said no game. What about Tails doesn't fucking count? You know that? Shut up. Yeah, look, we got no control over Tails. I mean, we're not playing two players, so yeah. Next boss is the Egg Drillster MK2 thing. So watch out for a little fire jet. Get some hits off on him. He's gonna drill to the ground, and holy crap, what's going on? There's a kind of shitty soft lock or whatnot here, but we don't gotta worry about it. So Tails is actually trying to be useful here for once. It's pretty crazy. And then Robotnik just flies away but comes back with a vengeance. Not really. And that's kind of it. But yeah, Tails will always pick us back up from our knowledge, so we can't die here, I'm pretty sure. Well, die from falling, specifically. The next boss is the Bowling Spin. It's Breakout, actually. We're playing Breakout. So we gotta hit the machine, which opens it up, and then we just have to get the top to hopefully, you know, hit the boss instead of hitting the blocks. It's very easy. It's a fun fight, but it could be over just like that, and then you forgot. Oh yeah, I was supposed to be having fun. I mean, it's fun. Not as fun as it could have been, but still fun. Next boss is the Egg Gravitron Ball thing. Yeah, Dr. Robotnik, he's not messing around this time. He has a machine, and inside it, there's a ball. It's fucking the craziest thing I've ever seen. Anyways, that's the whole fight. Yeah. So one TMNT bowling ball later, and we're done? The next boss is gonna freeze ya. It's this big ice dude. So, you know, he's got those three things. They're dangerous, obviously. So this fight might look a little familiar. Be very cautious as you go to hit him. It's very easy to get hit. Just like the Metropolis Zone boss from Sonic 2. But, yeah. long as you're careful, you can end it pretty quick and really not have to worry about Jack Diddley squat. Oh boy, it's time for the egg froster. It's gonna frost our eggs. So Eggman's gonna drop this thing, and we're gonna go up there, and we're gonna smack the shit out of Eggman. We need to be careful not to get frozoned by the, you know, the frozone mist. And, that's it. You know, I know this game is... This game has a lot of bosses. So, you know, not all of them are gonna be winners, okay? Not all of them are gonna be winners. The next boss is the Twin Hammer. Actually, I think it's... Only, I know there's apparently like a variation where you fight two, but it's still no different and not different enough for me to care. And I know someone's gonna be like, shush. Anyways, you just hit this when it's not spinning. The end. Yeah, the game has some variations when it comes to like Sonic, Tails, and then also just Knuckles. But Knuckles has unique bosses also, and that's what counts. The next boss is the Egg Cannon. This is a very uninspired, boring fight. So, he just kind of chills up there, occasionally tries to shoot a cannonball at us, and we move on. The final- just kidding, this is Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Anyways, the next boss is the Egg Rocket. You call that a rocket. So you can bounce, 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 but you gotta watch out for the little spike that's circling Robotnik's dome. And of course, you gotta watch out for the lasers as we destroy this whatever. Anyways, if you're playing the original Sonic 3 here, you do end up fighting the Big Arm, which is the final boss, I think. I might be wrong about that. Oh, I haven't played the base game for a long time. I've always just played with and Knuckles. Okay. Next boss is a lumberjack, and it's okay. Chops all night and sleeps all day. Dude, I don't know. It chops trees down. It could burn you with its jet. And, you know, just don't get burned. Don't get damaged. The next boss is the Jet Mobile. So, this fight definitely gives me visions of Sonic Advance and whatnot, with the running fights and stuff. So, you just want to jump into him, but be careful for his fire jet. And of course, be careful for the spike balls and stuff that are trying their best to be a hazard, but not really all that hazardous. It's not that bad. Next boss is the Gapsule. It's a capsule and it wants to kill you, but instead it's gonna kill itself because we're gonna have it just keep hitting its head. Stop hitting yourself, stop hitting yourself, stop hitting yourself. Stop. Anyways, yes, that's the whole strategy. Just have it smash its own skull and pretty sure that's not allowed. Oh well. At least there aren't no animals inside it, because that would be devastating. I saw a few animals. Oh well. And, yeah. That's that. A fistful of nothing! Hey, look! It's Barrier Eggman thing again. Technically V2, maybe V1, I don't know. Anyways, remember in Winged Fortress or whatever? Scott? Yeah. Sonic 2. It's basically this, except without any of the difficulty. It's like they gave the game a baby bottle. Like, here you go, take a little drink, here you go, watch out! So, basically, all you have to do is dodge. Because you can't do anything in this, you just wait. And then, it malfunctions. And you win. Thrilling, isn't it? It's just the most thrilling thing I've ever seen. Yep, that's it. The next boss is the Guardian, the Golem, the whatever the hell you want to call it. This is such a great fight. You can win by basically doing nothing. So, you're supposed to lead it over here. So, you know, Sonic and Tails can just chill over here. My bad. And by chill, I mean Tails is going to drown themselves in sand because they're just... It's their favorite pastime. poor Tails. So we're just waiting for our buddy to hippie hop pop over Mirko over here. And then we're gonna just hippie bop bop wham bam ba bam booble. Boom! Right into the sand. And Tails also apparently, because Tails is suicidal. But Tails is okay. Tails doll is not okay. There Tails goes again. The next boss is the Egg Golem. So you can kind of get yourself stuck inside Robotnik here and do a lot of damage, but you most likely will get hit if you're not cautious, so that's why I was trying to back off. This is basically the final boss of Sonic 2, except that it was really, 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 really ridiculously easy. Easier. Like, I feel like looking at it and its design, and it would be harder, but it's not. So, yep. That's that. The next boss is a bunch of tentacles and an arm. Finger arm. You hit it. You stop it from shooting bullets. You jump and don't get squished or just run around. That was fucking horrible of me, jeez. Anyways, after the tentacly things are taken care of, all you gotta do now is beat the piss out of this robotic hand. That's all that's left to do. And really, there's not much else to say. You just hit it. Yep. Like I said, there's a lot of bosses in this game. Not all of them are winners. A lot of them are. Anyway. Let's keep that train going, huh? Yeah? You ready? The next boss is the Hot Mobile. So, it starts off here, so this isn't a boss fight, but I consider this part of it, seeing as it leads into it in the music. So, we just gotta dodge some missiles, try not to stand on any of those platforms that fall, and eventually make our way all the way to the right. We can't damage the boss, because, you know, the boss was in the background, if you couldn't tell. You 100% want to grab the fire shield. You don't need it, but the fire shield makes this fight, like, infinitely easier. So, hey, you remember, if you played Rocket Knight Adventures, or watched the boss video I did on it, the lava fish, and the platforms that kept going towards it? Yeah, this fight's basically that. But with the lava shield, Sonic can just stand on the lava. This isn't a cheat. I'm not hacking. This is the game. If you don't have it, then no, you can't stand on the lava. You have to do it normally. You have to play Rocket Knight. Anyways, you might be wondering, why are you not attacking it? Well, that's because he beats the shit out of himself. It's very similar to the first boss in the Sega Game Gear Sonic 2, where they have the balls bouncing into the thing, and it is the first, right? Whatever. But yeah, we just have to have Eggman Botnik over here just constantly killing himself, and yeah, it's easy as that. I know someone's thinking, oh, it's easy because you're doing it with the... Hey, I'm allowed to use my resources. It's not my fault if you don't wanna. If you wanna make it slightly more of a challenge for your ego, you could just get rid of the shield. It's easy. I mean, heck, you could just walk in the Robotnik and hurt yourself. Get rid of the shield, too. Even if I wasn't using a fire shield, I would have ended up using the electricity thingamabobber for my jump powers. And yeah, but we're fire jump, man. So yeah, that's it. The next boss is Knuckles. Oh no. Yeah, you just hit Knuckles.
Oh no.
One at a time, slowly. Dodge his spinning, dodge his punching, hit him from below.
Oh no.
Yeah. It's Knuckles. What do you expect? Come on, it's not that.
Oh no.
Surprising.
Oh no.
It's not hard. I mean, come on, did you see the most recent movie? What?
Oh no.
The next boss is the Egg Mobile H piloted by Mechasonic. Yep, this is the first boss from Sonic the Hedgehog 1. Back in all of its glory to try to hit us with its ball. And we don't want to do that. And then, oh, look who's back. It's this fucking asshole from Metropolis Zone. Seriously, can we stop bringing this thing back? Jesus Christ. I'm just saying, we already had a fight to basically have this earlier in the ice stage. It wasn't good. And yeah, that is the whole fight, sadly. Oh boy, it's time to fight Mechasonic. This time, Gabloop. You gotta watch out, because, you know, moves around. His moveset isn't very straightforward. Sometimes he'll go up and then, like, do a dash. He'll bounce. He'll dash along the ground. And just, you know, be cautious and beat the shit out of it. Of course, if you want to fight it for real, you're gonna have to do that with Knuckles. The next boss is Red Eye, this stupid robot that I used to have a lot of issues with, and now I realize that there was no reason for that. So, you gotta hit it, obviously, when it's not protected by its balls. And this one's got a lot of balls. And we gotta avoid taking balls in the face. So every time you hit Red Eye, one of the balls will burst upward and explode into a spiky mess. Yeah. It is what it is. So, once you take out all of its balls, it's gonna get angry. You thought it was done, but it's got a new set of cojones. So, with this, depending on how you're doing this, if you're trying not to get hit, or just being overly cautious, you want to take this very slow. You want to hit the boss and get to the other side of the screen. You don't want them to be too close to you when you do it either. Because we're trying to wait out the laser. You can do this faster, obviously, if you don't care taking damage. It's really frustrating to try to do this any faster just normally. Like, going for two hits can do, but usually end up screwing that up. So, you know, taking it slow, taking it safe here. This is the strategy. I almost got hit by that. Tails did, but it's okay, because Tails is immortal, or there's just a lot of Tails. I don't know the lore here, the EXE. Let's not talk about that, okay? Let's not talk about Tails Doll, okay? Let's stop talking about Tails. The next boss is the Death Ball. So I actually used to really have a hard time with this, and I'm pretty sure if anyone watched the last video I did, the boss video, this was like a while ago, which I know some people did, I took forever and I got my ass destroyed. However, I've got a new strategy. So, what you're supposed to do for this fight is you yourself can't hurt the boss, because they got these bumpers on them. They got bumper cars, and you've got to watch out. So, let's fight things. They, when you switch gravity, also have their gravity switch. So, you know, we use that to our advantage to hit the boss. We want the spike end to hit them. We could also, if they're upside down, like, launch. You already see what I'm doing. You either use the gravity to make them, like, fall to the boss, or you yourself can hit them and try to launch them, like a Mecha Koopa, kind of. I mean, there's definitely faster ways, but I mean, this is a huge improvement over what I did last time I fought this, because outside of continuously taking damage, I fought this like I didn't know what the hell I was doing, because I did it. The next boss, and technically the final boss, technically, is the giant Eggman robot. There's a lot of final bosses. You know what? I don't even know when to put final boss on the screen. How about we just don't? Anyways. So, great music all around. So, walking over, I'm not sure where. We're in space. So, remember that hand from that other fight in the lava area? Yeah, it's back with a vengeance. Now there's two of them. Some crazy shit. Yeah, I know. Anyways, we have to break all six of their fingers because that's how this works. It's a little slow, a little boring. Really cool looking sprite, though. I gotta say that. I appreciate it. If you look inside the robot's right eye, its right eye, not our right, kind of looks a little spooky because you can see a large old eye in there. Just saying. Anyways, once the hands are gone, you're probably like, what's it gonna do now? Open its mouth and shoot freaking laser beams? Yes. Yes. Basically. Yeah, you thought it was over. But surprise! Now you come face to literal face with the final boss. Kind of, not really. So we gotta be cautious. Because when we hit the head, as you can see, it opens up the mouth cannon that has the emerald, the master emerald in it. So we gotta break this shit. We also gotta watch out for nose fire, because I just realized that the snot nose thing is canon, huh? Don't worry, don't question. I'm sure some people might understand why I just brought that up out of nowhere, but I don't want to say it. So, anyways, we're done here, basically. But now Eggman's grabbed the, he's trying to get away. Got the emerald, and we're not very happy about that. So, this part's basically unlosable, unless, of course, you want to jump off the edge. So, just try your best not to accidentally, you know? And with that, it's time. The final boss, technically, is the final weapon. This supersonic fight is cancer. I hate it so much. Because you don't got a lot of rings. Anyway, so, what we have to do here is we have to try our best, to lead these rockets into Robotnik's robot's face. This fight's fucking weird, because the movement and the boosting, I'm not sure, how it's done or how it's tracked, but sometimes those bullets that they're shooting ultra home in on you, and it almost feels like there's no way to avoid them. I'm not entirely sure what they did for this. It reminds me of a really shitty rubber band AI from a racing game. I can't believe I didn't get hit. So then you don't have a lot of time left. And just so people don't have to sit here for 25 years and watch as I farm 8,000 rings, we're gonna cut that forward, because trust me, it took me a while. So yeah, if you don't farm rings, you will die. And okay, here's the thing. This is where the controversy is gonna come in. The only thing that counts as taking damage in this fight is when you get hit by Eggman shit. Getting hit by the rocks and stuff, that is not taking damage. I know someone's gonna be like, but no, it's not. Okay, no, thank you. Anyways, so as you can see, we're over here. We're smashing an Eggman. We're trying to avoid his missiles, his little mine things or whatever, and yeah. So you just have to keep smashing into Eggman, because this is a supersonic fight. You already know what's happening. And you definitely have to make sure you are collecting rings before you came over here, because you need them or you die. And yeah, I know someone's going to want to fight me on my explanation from earlier, but deal with it. Anyways, this boss, the only fight is Knuckles. It's the Egg Drillster. And this time it's got a dude. So, basically, it shoots like a hook shot or whatever. Two of them. And then it goes along it. So, you just gotta hit it and be careful not to accidentally touch the fur. Because, that hurts. It's not too hard of a boss. I felt sorry. I wanted to put Knuckles stuff at the end. But, yeah, the unique boss is his Knuckles. Okay? Don't think there's anything that's ultra unique at this point, outside of a few things. I know someone is going to bring up a few things, but in my mind, those aren't unique, so you'll be fine. Last time I did a boss video on this, I completely forgot, two Knuckles bosses anyways, in general. One of them being the Hangmobile, I'm pretty sure. So, the Hangmobile, it just chills down there, not able to be damaged from my knowledge. Shoots up fire, and then, we get a chance to hit the boss, so be cautious for the fire, be cautious for the obvious obligatory spike wheels, and yeah, overall it's a very easy fight, and hey, this fight would come back in a much later time, from what I can think of, Sonic Mania, but shh, this isn't Sonic Mania, plus Sonic Mania is overall better, but everyone knows that, so, what? Anyways, yeah, that's the whole fight. Simple shit. I do find it funny that I completely forgot about this boss, though. This and also Big Arm initially.
Oh no!
So, I know we already fought this, but I'm gonna include this anyways, because this is the lead up into the next, the actual boss. Which I completely forgot to show last time I did this, because I actually forgot it existed. So, this fight is the same as how we did with Sonic. The only difference is it's going to be followed up by the original final boss from Sonic 3, which is the big arm. Ow. I just kicked my table that the microphone was on. Hopefully that wasn't loud. The big arm isn't much different from my knowledge in this.
Oh no.
So, yeah. You gotta be very cautious. Big arm is very easy to get hit by. When I'm going in for the jump, I'm like a little confident, but I'm also semi-unconfident because if you're not careful, it's very easy to take damage, you know, get grabbed basically. We want to avoid that. Eventually, once you do enough damage to Big Arm, you're going to see it go above you, and it's going to be like, when am I going to fall? Where am I going? Where are we dropping, boys? And eventually, he drops. And he's going to go around the ground, the robot ears, back and forth. Obviously, there's spikes on top of the headpiece. We don't want to touch the spikes, because that would be bad. And from this point, we just repeat, repeat, repeat. I think the only difference, if I'm correct, in the Sonic 3 version is that I think it goes into the phase, the one where it goes above. I think it does it quicker, so it happens more often. I could be wrong, but yeah, so there you go. Big arms in the video this time. Are you entertained? God! Yeah, I almost forgot. The next boss is Egg Mobile. Oh no, Knuckles is captured. Shit, well clearly we goofed. Better do a re-recording. Seriously, just kidding, this is the final boss for Knuckles. Specifically, this is Metal Sonic, obviously. So, just like how we fought with Sonic, it's not too severely different, I think. Just, you know, some bouncing, etc. You can get off a lot of great hits really easily, and then move on to the actual fight, because, you know, it happens finally. What happens? Dragon. Anyways, don't worry about it. So, Metal Sonic Chaos Emerald, sorry, the Master Emerald. Somehow, not sure how that works. Turns into Metal Supersonic, whatever, you know. So, you gotta be careful. We can't damage them while they're glowing. They're literally fucking invincible. But you can go for a hit once they're coming down. When they're shooting the orbs, obviously you want to dodge their orbs. But always be cautious because there's a chance that they are not going to use the orbs. They're actually going to try and ram you, which has caught me off guard a few times thinking it was going to be a different attack. And yeah, try your best not to get caught off guard. So here come the balls again. Boom, boom, boom. And the Metal Sonics or whatever. It's like, boom. Get it. Whoop, whoop. Gets on the emerald. Boom. So I go for two hits. I don't know if you can go for a third, and I really don't care enough to go for a third. This isn't a speed run. I just feel safe hitting them when they're coming down after doing their pew 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 attack right here.
Oh no.
Even though I just completely fucked that up. And then hitting them as they go on. But you have to be careful and quick, because you want to hit them before they start charging themselves with the power from your Master Emerald. Otherwise, you're going to be in a world of pain, kid. So, yeah, don't do that. Anyways, we just continue this process until that's it, really. Until it's over. And before I upload this, oh yeah, and they also have a weird ring attack that they did at the end there that I've only ever like seen that like once or twice, so weird. Yeah. Anyways, unless that's their final attack. Anyways, yes, I am gonna look up stuff before I upload this just to make sure, so don't tell me. So which boss is your favorite, least favorite, and why? Leave a comment in the comments down below. My favorite, honestly, is Metal Sonic / Super Metal Sonic with Knuckles. I don't know, I like it. And yeah, of course, my least favorite boss, I really want to say the Super Sonic fight, and I probably am going to say it's, yeah, but also the Egg Cannon, because it's just, it's a dud. But, yeah, no, my least favorite boss is both phases of the Super Sonic fight. Because my issue with Sonic games is there has rarely ever been a good Super Sonic fight in the history of Sonic games. And I know that hearing that, someone's going to want to start a debate, and that's cool. But it's just my opinion, so don't freak out. As I'm making this video, I know, obviously, outside of, like, the Sega Genesis, you could play this on some of the collections on, like, the GameCube, PS2, etc., I know that there's that new Sonic 2D game coming out that every time I mention it, I forget its name, but I'll put it in the description. It's not... Well, as I'm making this video, it's not out. But pretty sure it includes, like, this or something. And I don't know, like I said, Sega Genesis... Sorry. Sega puts their shit all over the place, so... There will always be a way to play your favorite Sonic games, so, you know... Yeah. If you enjoyed the video, consider leaving a like and subscribing. Of course, if you didn't like the video, you could always dislike it. And then, you know, give me the Master Emerald and force me to have a Super Sonic fight. Because I ain't gonna have any fun with it, okay? You know what? You take the Master Emerald back. Here, you have it. You take this burden. Anyways, seriously, hope you enjoyed. I do this for fun, so hopefully you have fun watching. I do like this game. I just, you know, prefer Sonic 2 much more in Sonic Mania and etc. So, yeah. And, you know, there's just a lot of duds in this game when it comes to the bosses specifically. And, like I said, I am going to look into stuff before I upload this. So if you don't see anything else added that, yeah, I disagree with some of the fights being unique. Anyway, see you next video.